British Royal Botanic Garden has recently published a top-line research according to which about 600 plant species have disappeared from the wild over the last 250 years. This number is based on the real facts and not on some predictions or estimations. In addition, this number is twice more than the number of all extinct birds, mammals, and amphibian combined. Scientists claim that the plant's extinction is now 500 times faster than it could be expected to happen in a natural way. Some of them even believe that we live in the age of the sixth mass extinction. The researchers also reckon that the analysis of this unique set of all extinct plants will help to figure out what measures are required to prevent the extinction in future. For the first time, we have an idea of already extinct plants, and besides, we know about the place and the frequency of their disappearance. Many people can name mammals or birds that have become extinct in recent centuries, but it's more difficult to name extinct plants. If you know at least one plant, leave a comment below, and if you don't, then try to name any extinct animal. This report is the last one in a series of grim studies on the human impact on the world. In May 2019, 145 experts from 50 countries of the Intergovernmental Group on Biodiversity and Ecosystem Services gave their assessment to the situation. Today, there is about a million species that are at risk of extinction, among about 8 million of all existing species of plants and animals. Some of the species may even disappear in the next decade. The global extinction frequency is already dozens or even hundreds times higher than the average frequency for the last 10 million years. Okay, maybe scientists are just exaggerating. But how about the fact that the insect's biomass is constantly reducing by 2.5% every year? Still, we all think insects are somewhat unkillable and adaptable to any conditions. The Guardian research states that a third of all insect species are already on the verge of extinction. Another 40% are slowly going this way. If this tendency evolves, there may not be any insects on the Earth after 100 years from now on. Thinking that insects' extinction will happen for the best is a big mistake. Remember the bees and some other insects that pollinate plants? Besides, every farmer would tell you how helpful dung beetles are. No wonder why they were once imported to Australia on purpose to improve soil fertility. Let's take a look at the examples of already extinct plants. The Chilean sandalwood, which was valued for a rare woody, resinous and rich aroma with a misty musky tint, and St. Helens olive, that died 15 years ago despite many attempts to resurrect it. It's also worth to mention a herbaceous plant of Sardinia perea, an endemic of Madagascar. It was discovered and described in 1914 with just one single sample. And now, no matter how long you stay in Madagascar, you are more likely to find Alex, Marty, Gloria and Melman dancing to the catchy music with King Julian from the famous cartoon rather than see this plant. Today people grow rice, make pastures for zebu, or sometimes they even burn the grass in the places where Sertida used to grow. All scientists believe the human factor to be the main global extinction reason. Even if we don't take into account environmental problems, we just face a simple fact anyway. People displace animals from their habitats. Construction, mining, agriculture. We take away from the nature its territory year after year. By 2070, there will be 2,000 more species that will lose half of their habitat territories. If we eliminate all humans from the Earth right now, the nature will have to take 7 million years to recover to the state it was before we arrived. It is also stated in the research that the highest plant extinction frequency is on the islands, in tropical areas, or in the Mediterranean climate zones. For example, over the past 250 years, 79 species of seed plants have disappeared in Hawaii, and in South Africa, 37. The same situation happened in Australia, India, Madagascar again, and Brazil. And it's not surprising, taking into account that the famous Amazon jungle has been cut down to 17% for the past 50 years. Now let's take a look at the ecology problems. The volume of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere has increased. This gas is produced by cars and other people's entertainments. This increase is not so big, but it exists and it's going up. Over the last 30 years, half of the beautiful reefs of our Mother Nature have already died. It's easy to get a calculator and figure out when we will totally lose them. The complete guilt of humanity in global warming has not been proven yet, but undoubtedly there is some certain extent in it. Global warming really kills fish because not all underwater guys like to swim in a warm water. For example, last year thousands of mullets were cooked alive in California. They can hardly tolerate the water temperature above 77 degrees Fahrenheit. Any little heating up is fatal for them. And here are some more facts about the plants. Scientists from the Royal Botanic Garden and from Stockholm University have found that 571 plant species have disappeared over the past 2.5 centuries. This number is twice as large as the number of extinct birds, mammals, and amphibians, 217 species. These data show that the plant's extinction occurs 500 times faster than in normal conditions. In other words, if there were no humans on the planet. The researchers believe that even these figures do not show the real situation of plants' disappearance. The information obtained from this analysis will be crucial in preventing the extinction in future. They are also sure that the human activity, like deforestation and agricultural land expansion, is the main cause of plants and animals' extinction. But there is a beam of light in the darkness. 430 species that were once considered to be extinct have been recently rediscovered. Rediscovery of species previously considered extinct often means finding just a few survivors. So 90% of newly discovered plants are still at a high risk to disappear. Why does the plant's extinction really matter? The answer is as easy as ABC. The life on the Earth depends on plants. These green guys provide us with the oxygen we breathe and give us the food to eat. Plants' extinction can lead to a cascade of other extinction, like insects, which use plants for food, for home, and for egg laying. Well, plants' extinction is bad news for everyone. The current situation is terrifyingly similar to the past. The greatest extinction in the history, the Permian extinction in Russia, happened because of the Siberian volcano's activity. Those volcanoes have been erupting for years, throwing soot and ash in the air, which blocked the sunlight. Of course, it was enhancing the greenhouse effect. Now we do the same with the products of combustion. Seems like people are enjoying while helping this process. 250 million years ago, the global warming, hot oceans, and lack of oxygen took down 96% of animals and more than 70% of the plants. Ring a bell, huh? The researchers call everyone to take some urgent measures to stop plants' extinction. First, register all the plants around the world. Second, keep the herbarium containing plant samples. It is necessary for our successes. We also need to support botanists who conduct important researches and teach our children to notice and recognize local plants. Any life requires care and a proper treatment, and not only from charity organizations. Meanwhile, we see how large corporations, responsible for more than a half of the emissions into the atmosphere, offer us to quit using plastic bags to save our future. But it's just hypocrisy, greed, and ostentation. They never did anything good. For now, the situation on the Earth is just moving in the same dangerous direction. And we can only dream that it will ever change.